Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Friday Night Live. Tonight, it's a new beginning, Caveman Night. And the reason for this is we've discovered the most perfectly fossilized and preserved Neanderthal caveman in human history.
That's right. Now, parents at home, if you have children, we urge you, cover their eyes. We do not want to be responsible for any nightmares.
Under this sheet is the Fitzius Idiotus.
Bro, come back, Shepherd. Over the top, yep, off you go.
This is Friday Night Live!
My name is Mike Goldman, and this is our live studio audience. Pumped, ready to rock. The first Friday Night Live of 2006. This is the show that will physically and mentally challenge our new batch of housemates and make you laugh more than a hyena being tickled with a funny-looking feather in a laughing gas factory. Big Brother took me aside last week and said, Mike, I have some good news and I have some bad news. The good news is that every Friday I'll be joined by a woman who's so beautiful that a driving license will be sold on eBay for $1 million, the lovely Miss Bree, Amer. She's on TV and she's kissing me. And the bad news is that I'll be joined by a man who's not allowed to put his photo on the internet because it might be considered as a virus, Mr. Ryan Bitsy Fitzgerald! Bitsy! Bitsy, he's the man, footy star. We've got the housemate now on TV.
Hi, Mike. Hi,
buddy. How you going, mate?
Yeah, not too bad, thanks.
You're both well? Have you been since Friday Night Games?
Oh, excellent in that long week.
Yeah, it's been great. Thanks for the week off to the producers for the massive holiday that we had after Friday Night Games.
We are at such an exciting time of Big Brother.
It's massive.
It is absolutely awesome. We've got the insider in the house, Michael sneaking around behind the scenes. He's trying to figure out who has the relationship in the Big Brother house.
It is, of course,
Karen and Crystal.
Isn't he as blunt as a sledgehammer? He's as good at keeping secrets as Shane Warne.
And
he's
terrible. Can I say, he's got no idea, I reckon. No. Absolutely no idea. I think he's asking Karen and Crystal too much, who he reckons they are, like who the insider is. Well, he's got no idea.
He's madly in love with Crystal as well. So if he only knew that the secret he had to find is right under his nose and the girl that he adores.
I know, I think that's working against him, though. He's getting very close to Crystal and it's probably, you know, blindsiding him to the truth.
Well, a big night tonight, of course. The idea of Friday Night Live, as you know, is to shape up the house by pitching the housemates against each other in a series of games that will ultimately produce one winner. If you've never seen it before, this is how we humoured them last year.
You're a hard act to follow. Such a fine-looking fellow. I hear your belly is yellow. You're a hard act to swallow. It kind of makes me sick. The way you turn those tricks. Come on, light it up. I wanna feel the rush.
Lovely.
Getting a bit emotional, Mike.
Yes, I am. That happens. Each week, The games are themed, and tonight it's the new beginning. But let's be honest, that's just a cool way of saying caveman night. I'm glad I wasn't a caveman. Imagine how horrible it would be knowing that there's 2 billion sleeps until Christmas.
That'd be
awful.
Have you
met any cavemen, Bree?
That's a great
joke. Well, no, but I reckon if Fitzy had a bit of a shave, then, you know, if the caveman had a bit of a shave, it'd just look like Fitzy.
It's a great idea, though, isn't it? It's the first Friday Night Live back, and they've started with the new beginning.
A new beginning.
The writers here are just brilliant at Big Brother, aren't they? They're just really, really good.
OK, last year, the prize for the winner of Friday Night Live was massive. This year, it's even... Massive. There are four reasons why the housemates will want to win every single Friday. Fitzy, tell them what the first prize is.
Well, we all know what the first one is, don't we? It is the world famous rewards room.
Ah, yes.
Yes.
Fitzy, tell us all about it in a real stupid voice.
The winner of tonight's games receives two fabulous nights in the Eastern-inspired retreat, also known as the Rewards Room. The room features a queen-sized, ebonized, antique waterbed that's been filled with melted sacred snow from Mount Fuji. The bathroom is a tranquil haven with stylish fittings, a deep bathtub, and an elaborate drinking fountain, also known as a bidet. Featuring genuine Chinese antique furniture, a traditional Japanese kimono, and a 1,500-year-old bonsai, you can sit back, pour yourself a green tea, and enjoy your 42-inch plasma. This lavish prize is proudly brought to you by our friends at Big Brother.
Yeah!
Explain it to you later, mate.
No drinking out of the bidet.
Okay, Bree, tell us what the second part of the prize is.
Well, of course they get to assign the household chores, which is massive. You can, you know, annoy a few people by doing this. We've got groundskeeper, we have shopper chef, we have housekeeper, kitchen hand, baker, and the janitor, which is a new job.
What?
And let me say, it is shocking.
Why,
it's
the
worst one of them.
Janitor?
I'm not telling you.
Cleaning the toilet? What is that?
No, I'm not telling you.
Not
it's
telling.
A surprise.
Okay.
Ooh,
and of course, we have the farmhand.
The farm?
Now, where are the animals, you ask? Well, we've put them in there today. Here's the exclusive. They are in front of the arena, so they're in the house this time. And look, we've got some little lambies. One male, one female.
Lamb
and they're both
roast. There's
five
a little
weeks
lamb
old,
roast.
Aren't
the
they
mint
cute?
Sauce out.
Aw, little lambies. And we've also got some kids.
You can't have kids
both
in the house.
They're 3 weeks old. They're just gorgeous. And the deer, of course. Two male. And one is 4 weeks old and one is 2 weeks
little
old.
Bambi.
They're lovely.
Hey, Bambi, I've got some bad news about your mother.
Oi! That's not nice.
Actually, the farm animals aren't in the games arena. They're just outside.
Just outside, yeah, in front of the
eviction doors.
Are the farm animals on the shopping list?
No!
Can you eat them?
Okay, the third part of the prize is the ability to change the nominations to have a direct effect on who goes up for eviction. This is massive. There's a lot of money at stake here. Once the nominees are announced on Monday night, the winner of tonight's games can take 3 points off anyone who's nominated by their fellow
That's
housemates.
That's a great rule, isn't it, Mike?
And now comes the fourth and newest part to the Friday Night Live equation. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready. I give you the three boxes. Yes, later in tonight's show. Thank you very much. I got a bit emotional then, a bit excited. Later in tonight's show, Bree and Ryan, maybe even myself if I'm lucky, will be putting three prizes into these three boxes. One prize per box. The boxes will be taken to the rewards room and the winner of tonight's game chooses a box and wins the prize inside.
What is it?
Oh, well, don't open it.
It's a great idea, isn't it? Great idea.
We'll tell you a little later in the show, okay? One of the prizes is absolutely massive.
Huge.
All right? It's not just rewards room for the week.
Yep.
It kills that, all right? Okay, Ryan?
What is the other one?
What's
well, if one's absolutely massive, the other one is absolutely deplorable, all right?
One,
so there's a real shocking present in there as well.
One stinks, okay? But more about that later. Let's just say tonight more than ever, these housemates will definitely want to win. Earlier today, Big Brother thought of an ingenious way to pick tonight's two team captains. Take a look.
This is Big Brother. Karen and Crystal, you are the first two housemates out of bed this morning. For this reason, tonight you will captain the two teams in the first Friday night games.
Yes! Well, there you have it, Karen and Crystal.
Ooh,
tonight's team captains, both teams have airbags. What do we make of that?
Well, you know what? I think it's a really good fluke of selection because Karen and Crystal are so competitive and Karen is determined to beat Crystal. Mm. So let's have a look at her profile, shall we?
Mm-hmm.
Let's check out how we think she's going to do tonight.
Do you know that as well? See, now, when they woke up this morning, that was the first time they've been alone together as mother and daughter.
Ooh. Yeah. Now, working for her, she's got maturity. But working against her, on the con side of things, she is the oldest housemate. Oh.
She doesn't look old, though. She's damn hot.
And you know what? Like, for a mother,
yeah.
My God, she looks about 12.
She had three kids.
Well, she is
amazing.
A good captain. I think she'll be a great captain, but I think the young fella, Crystal's going to be an even better captain. Let's have a look at her advantages and disadvantages. And disadvantages, parental supervision, because you don't want your mum hanging around and saying, look, clean your teeth, put your undies on. Whereas advantage-wise, it is good to have parental supervision, I reckon, because she's your backup. She can sort of look out for you. She's your wingman.
Keep
she's
in mind,
not going
to
help them from another team, though. They're too competitive.
They're trying to keep the secret for a week that their mother and daughter inside the Big Brother house. And under pressure in Friday Night Live, one of them could yell out, well, Crystal could yell out, oh, Mum.
Mum.
Could happen.
Go, Mum.
Could wreck it for themselves. Well, as you can see behind me, the housemates are cavemaned up and ready to rumble. So let's go down to the house and get this show on the road.
You're but you're still feeling your neck.
This is Big Brother. All housemates to the garden immediately. Housemates stand on the white line facing the tables.
White line.
This morning, Karen and Crystal were the first two housemates out of bed. Therefore, they are captains of tonight's games. Karen, stand behind the blue table. Crystal, stand behind the red table. Captains, you must now choose your teams, one player at a time. Wait for Big Brother's instructions before making each selection. Housemates, when your name is called, stand behind your captain. Karen, name your first player.
Galen.
Crystal, name your first player.
Tilly.
Karen.
John.
Crystal.
Michael.
Katie.
Karen.
No. Katie.
Yeah. Chaos.
Crystal.
Claire.
Karen.
Anna.
Anna.
Oh. Jamie.
Crystal.
Dino.
Mysterious.
Karen.
Jamie.
Yes.
Oh, Jamie. Go, team, go. This is the top team, this is.
Crystal.
Elise.
She wants to eat everything.
Yeah.
Karen.
Oh, yeah.
Ashley.
Oh, Basher.
So we are live in front of her.
Crystal.
I'm going to be last.
How many girls do we have?
We need more boys.
David. We need more boys. Okay. We need more boys. Sorry, David.
Oh, look at your hair, David.
Rock star.
Yeah. Oh, Camilla. Come with us.
Camilla. You have not been selected.
What?
By your fellow housemates. Remain where you are.
It's like backyard cricket.
Hello.
Wow.
Yeah, there's one extra girl.
It would appear
They don't want you in their teams.
Oh, no!
However, Big Brother believes you should have a chance to compete. Camilla, Big Brother is putting you straight through to the second round. Congratulations.
Yay!
Housemates, it's time to enter the arena.
Yeah, come on!
Big Brother! Two lefties!
We got the best team.
I had the tactic working.
Housemates, enter the arena through the silver doors now.
Good catch, man.
Housemates, stand on the yellow zone and face the Big Brother house.
Housemates,
tonight is the new beginning. You'll take part in a series of games which will test your prehistoric skills.
No.
You'll play in teams, but there will be only one winner. Tonight, housemates, you're playing for 48 hours in a luxurious rewards room with a housemate of your choice.
Big Brother.
Two, the right to allocate household chores. Three, the power to change nominations. And four, a special prize, which will be revealed later. That is all.
Well, yabba dabba doo, a special prize, the chores, the rewards room, the nomination points.
And what about the mystery prop? This is massive. Like, it's going to be so competitive to win this Friday Night Live every Friday.
And how's Camilla getting chosen last? Does that mean she's the least popular person in the house? Well, could that mean she could go on Sunday night when the housemates vote who leaves?
I think no matter what, that's how she'd be feeling. And I must say, like, picking teams like that, it potentially shows your preferences with housemates and could affect nominations.
No, it doesn't.
That's the way that I would think
about it. You've got to pick your strongest team. Okay, which team is going to win?
I said potentially.
Who's the strongest? Who's going to win? Who's your team?
I'm going to go Crystal's team. I'm going to go the young girl's team.
Yeah, I'm going with Karen. Okay, you're going Karen. Are we picking individuals here?
Well, I mean, who's going to stand out? We'll talk more about that after the break. All right, Crystal's team will go first because Karen was first out of bed. Okay? It's Friday. It's live. This is Friday Night Live.
What's your motto?
Put games in Friday Night Games, boys.
Women can do anything.
Not to fall on my ass and make a fool of myself.
If flirting was a sport, I'd win this thing.
I'll do anything to win.
Losing to me will be inevitable.
I don't have a competitive bone in my body.
That's where they have the games, isn't it?
I'll use brains over brawn.
I didn't come here to play second, so bring it on.
Friday Night Live of the series. I'm Mike Goldman, joined by the pretty Miss Bree Amer the pretty pungent Ryan Fitzgerald.
Oh, there.
Now, you might have noticed when we came back from the commercial break, you saw all the housemates talking about Friday Night Games. Mm. They don't realise that the show's live, so anything could happen here tonight.
So that's why we still call it Friday Night Games, because we don't want them to know that it is a live element.
Yeah. So who's going to be the contenders tonight, Fitzy?
Well, I'm going the young girls' team. Crystal, captain of that team, and I think they have three strong points in the team. I'm going to go through some competitors right now. Let's have a look at some player profiles. Let's kick it off with Dino.
Yep.
I think Dino is a massive competitor. Watch out for him now. Some of the pros and cons. The pros is he has a Flintstone name. Dino the Dolph.
Oh,
so he's perfect for tonight.
Dino
bit
the
of
Dinosaur.
A con, he's a bit of a mummy's boy.
Oh.
So he might get hurt. Let's get on to Claire, one of the females of the team. Claire Bear. Now, one of the big pros is that she tames massive cats. So she's not scared of anything. She gets stuck into tigers. One con is she's Ian Thorpe. She's got size 13 feet. Not many
what?
People know that about
she
Claire.
She has not.
Yeah, oh, my God.
She's wearing joking. Flippers. And the last one, David. Now, he said he hasn't got a competitive bone in his body, but one of the pros is he looks great on a horse, doesn't he, ladies? And another point is he's got good corned beef, teeth, great teeth.
Okay, Bree, tell us yours. Who do you think's going to win tonight? Who's going to do well?
Well, of course, I've gone with Karen's team, even though she also says she's not very competitive. So I reckon the three that are going to do really well tonight is Galen. He will definitely do well. Let's take
Galen.
A look. See, now, his pro is he is the tallest housemate, so if you need to reach for anything, you know, that's fine. He'll win it.
Yep.
But working against him is his name.
Yeah.
Really? Come on.
Galen.
Thanks,
Paris. Are we going to get over his name eventually?
No, we're not.
Galen.
Next up, we've got Jamie. Now, he's a personal trainer, the fittest of the fit. Anything physical, he'll be there. Working against him is his hair accessories. Like, come on. It's going to fall down, fall over his face, make him blind. Who knows?
He looks like Stifler.
And last but not least, we have Katie. Little Katie. Now, she's a bodyboarder, so she's, you know, quite fit.
Yeah,
but
right.
Working against her, she's a chicken. Also, she loves chicken. She can't live without chicken. It's Friday night. She's got no chicken.
Wow,
she's going to be angry at her dad.
That's a really good advantage, Bree. She loves chicken,
no.
So she's going to do well at the games tonight.
She's got no hormones pumping her up. And she did say when she was coming into the house that she never got more frustrated than when her dad forgot the chicken on Friday nights.
Yep.
It's Friday. There's no chicken.
Don't we all love chicken?
So there are the views of our so-called experts. Let's go down to the arena for game one.
It's Big Brother. Housemates. In the first game, you have 3 minutes to transport as many eggs as possible from the dinosaur nest at one end of the balance beam to the egg cups at the other. The team with the most unbroken eggs in their cups at the end of the 3 minutes wins. Karen's team, your job is to use the club to stop Crystal's team. Housemates, the game will start on the buzzer.
Oh, and they're off and racing. Now, not only are these dinosaur eggs full of water, but they're actually also greased up. Because, of course, here on Friday Night Live, we don't make things easy, so we cover them in Vass.
Oh, look at that. He looks like an 80-year-old woman.
He got it to the nest, but then lost it.
Now, keep in mind that they actually are strapped to bungee cords, so hitting them on that little panel is not as easy as it looks.
Now, the rules are here. You're not allowed to push them with your club. You've got to smack them.
It's a
broken. You've got to hit them.
Michael's laying it like a chicken.
Come on, Dave.
How's the size of those eggs? That's one big breakfast.
He's always lived on a farm. He never thought it would do much harm.
It's all about timing, because those guys are all strapped to these massive bungee cords that are pulling him back. Here comes a team leader, Crystal.
It's under 2 minutes to go.
Oh.
She's got a couple of extra pads there to soften the blow.
Now, I think...
Oh, she's almost losing it.
I think dinosaurs actually became extinct because they couldn't figure out how to tie the knot in the... Egg.
Oh, Elise!
Oh, Elise. She lost it.
Right, here goes Claire. Hold
it. No, you can't jab.
Hold it like a little baby.
You cannot jab the housemates.
That's it, no jabbing.
No jabbing.
Well, that was a jab.
Oh, she's doing well.
She's check it out. She's clinging onto that like it was one of her little baby cats at the zoo.
She's done well. Used to handling the eggs and babies.
Whoa!
One more minute to go. These guys are doing fantastically.
Oh, you can't. You're off, Big Brother.
I'm trying to hit me.
Oh, that's a jab. You've got to... I'm not allowed to jab, Big Brother said.
Spots. You must swing the club.
Oh, Dino's lost his egg. Dino the dinosaur. tractor on a tanty.
Oh, I nearly dropped it on the way in. What's going on? Oh.
30 seconds to go. The first team, Crystal City.
30 seconds.
At the moment, I think they've got about 3 eggs.
Go on, Davo, get down.
They've got 4 eggs so far.
No, David, use your good looks to get along the pole. Distract them with your striking good looks.
20 seconds to go.
Oh, he's off.
David's fallen off the pole.
Oh, Tilly's going to get knocked over again.
Oh, 10 seconds.
Run.
Go, Crystal.
Team leader. Run. 3. And that's it. Time is up.
No.
Here comes the hooter. Did Elise actually get one there?
I don't know.
I don't think
this
she did.
This is Big Brother. Crystal's team, you have collected 4 eggs in 3 minutes. Karen's team, this is your score to beat. That is all.
Well, yeah, not a bad effort there. 3 eggs, and we only got like 1 when we were rehearsing it.
Yeah.
They started very well. They got those 3 pretty early, and then they couldn't get any more after that. It's pretty tough, hey? If you take the legs out, you saw Tilly go blind.
Yeah, look at Tilly. Actually, we've got that as a replay. Take a look. She had a full-on stack here.
Watch
here she
this.
Goes and... oh, no jabbing,
watch
Karen.
Watch the old legs go out.
Hey, that's gotta hurt.
I tell you what, an interesting observation is, you know, it's a week into the show now. They've been in there together for a week. By now, someone would be really annoying you. So it'd be a good bit of, you know, venting of frustration.
Yeah,
and you'd club the people that were annoying you the most, really.
Okay, well, so the target to beat for Karen's team is 4 eggs. Can they do it? Can they?
Yeah.
No, yes.
Easy. They'll do it easy.
We'll find out after the break. This is Friday Night Live. This is Bree. And tonight we've taken a trip way back in time, the new beginning, and our brave housemates are playing prehistoric games in caveman style. Bree, who on your team do you think won't go so well tonight?
Well, look, I don't think Anna's our strongest competitor. Let's have a look at her profile. I think she'd be more likely to, you know, kind of forfeit
and
break a nail or anything like that.
Come on, Anna.
So working, you know, against her, she's a little bit precious.
Oh, why?
But a pro is that she always looks great. So maybe she can distract the other team with her striking.
What's she precious for? What do you mean?
Well, you know, she's a girly girl.
She's high maintenance, Bree. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Are you picking on her, Bree?
She's hard work.
You just don't like her because she's good looking.
Yeah. What about?
I love her.
What about her family?
Don't put words
friends
into my mouth.
She's not high maintenance to them, and you have a crack at her.
You want to hope they're not in the eviction show crowd on Sunday
you
night.
You two both just want to hit on her.
That's not true.
Bitsy, who you reckon in that last round?
I think it's a con that she's good looking. But I'll tell you one girl that's who's going to fire up now because she just got her legs taken out. It's like football. Once you get a knock, you're going to go in a little bit hard.
Sucked.
It's Tilly, the young filly Tilly. Let's have a look. And one disadvantage is that her name rhymes with silly. All right.
She just had a spilly.
That doesn't help. That doesn't help at all. But another pro is that on her side she's flexible, which is.
So it's one of the games.
She's flexible to meet you on a Friday night down at a restaurant if you want.
So it's one of the games.
Or does that mean that she can get a leg up behind her in there? I don't know what that means.
Apparently the strategy's being worked out right now for Crystal's team. We just heard from Big Brother that apparently Michael and Dino are going to work together and run together. So we'll see how they go.
And they're going to take out the legs, Mike.
They're
going to take out the legs
as well.
Together.
Well, as you can see behind us on the Super Duper Friday Night Live giant plasma screen, the ninjas have made their final adjustments. And Karen's team are ready to rumble. Remember, they have to beat a total of 4 dinosaur eggs. Let's see if they can do it.
You've got rubber.
This is Big Brother. Karen's team, you have 3 minutes to transport as many eggs as possible from the dinosaur basket along the beam to the egg cups. Crystal's team, your job is to hinder them. Housemates, prepare to compete.
Come on.
jump forward.
It's a tough one. Let's see if he counts that one. We'll have to see at the end.
Here comes Stippler.
He's a big rock, Jamie. He's doing well.
Hey, by the looks of things, another dinosaur needs more calcium in her diet, doesn't she? These eggs are looking a bit soft.
Dude, where's my dinosaur egg?
Look at the way they place them.
Oh, little Johnny. Oh, Johnny's straight through.
Champion.
Oh. They've tied already. They need four to win, don't they?
Yep.
No, they had four to tie. Katie.
Come on, Mandra.
Katie's got really long nails, so she could burst the egg very easily.
Come on, Katie. Take your legs out.
Oh. No jabbing. Oh. You're not allowed to throw it.
Oh, you may she... not throw the club.
And she's jumped up on the side and she's coming in.
That's up to Big Brother's discretion, Fitzy. Yeah. Right. Not yours.
We'll have to see how many actually.
Oh, that's it. Yeah, that's it. Okay. They've beaten them with 1 minute 34 to spare.
He's just held on to that one. Well, here comes Anna,
the girl who
Bree thinks is high maintenance.
Oh, stop it!
Here's the girl that Bree doesn't like.
Oh, can everyone please make
Anna's got to make
these words into my mouth.
Oh, she popped one pretty hard there.
Shit.
Look how much they're winning by. This is incredible.
Now, remember that these eggs are greasy.
Gail and gone. With an illegal jab too, I might add.
That's a jab,
Nice work from Jamie, the personal trainer. He's a muscle powerhouse.
Hey, Johnny!
Johnny!
Oh, he got off to
Johnny
such a
needs
good
a
start.
Rico.
He needs some more wax in his hair.
30 seconds.
You know he puts surfboard wax in his hair, John?
I know, crazy.
Oh, he's jumped back on.
You're not allowed to get back on.
That's Ashley.
It's good to see they're still going with determination, even though they've obviously won.
Oh, he's just put that one down.
Evil, so I think, anyway.
Here goes Karen, the mum. Oh, bad luck, Taz.
I was a bit weak.
Here comes Katie.
Yeah, come here, Katie.
Poor Katie.
Now, see, the key here is to hit the egg and burst it.
Oh, my boots are soaked.
Eight eggs, great effort. Well done.
Well, how many of them are legit, though, Mike? That's a question.
Well, I guess we'll have to wait for Big Brother's announcement to find out.
They're celebrating prematurely, who knows? Who knows? Like, honestly, Big Brother, he can turn at any point.
So,
what's going to happen now? I believe Big Brother will be disqualifying the other team from competition because...
What?
Yeah.
You're making that up.
They've gone. You watch.
This is Big Brother. Karen's team. You collected eight eggs.
Seven, I cheated.
However,
seven.
Big Brother has disallowed several eggs. Because you cheated.
Yeah.
You jumped from the beam. The number of eggs that's been disallowed is 3.
Yes.
They won by one.
Crystal's team, you collected 4 eggs. Karen's team, you are the winners of the 3 to the next round. That is all.
Well, there you go. Nice. Karen's team through. Gail and John, Katie, Anna, Jamie and Ashley. And so that means that Camilla is going to be back into the competition now for the second round.
Controversy there. Game one of Friday Night Live.
Yes.
We don't like games that are straightforward.
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, why don't we take a look at Camilla and see how we think that she will go in the games. Do you think she's going to go
Great idea.
Right? Yeah. I mean, she wasn't chosen by any of the housemates when they were picking who they wanted in the team. She was last. So Big Brother said, okay, yep, we'll put her through to the second round. What do you think of that?
And yet, you know what? On their profiles and their background, Camilla's actually one of the sportiest out of all of the female housemates. So it could have been, you know, a very bad decision on Crystal's part.
She could be a lot of help out there, actually. Mm. Well, it will be interesting to see. And like I mentioned before, the double eviction on Sunday night, it's going to be absolutely massive.
Massive.
A, the housemates have no idea that there's going to be an eviction on Sunday night.
Yep.
And B, they think it might be just one person being evicted. And also, they have to vote for who they want to go. It's not a public vote.
Two poor people have only spent a week in the house and they get evicted.
How devo would you be, really? I know, I can't imagine having to sit there and nominate
1 week
at that early point, you know, in the show. And it's because you're not nominating just to get them up for nomination.
Yeah.
You're nominating to boot them out. It's a completely different ballgame.
The Daily Show from 6:30 on Sunday, you might be able to decide it from that, who gets kicked out in the eviction show straight after it. Okay, we're going back to the arena now and Big Brother's going to get Camilla back into the games.
Yes. Oh, Andre.
This is Big Brother. Camilla. You are back in the game.
Yeah, Camilla!
Join Karen's team now.
Yeah, we got a new member. Welcome to the team.
Players.
This is the team of Karen. Ease up, ease up.
Split yourselves into two teams of four now.
Girls
split the girls.
One team, the man on the yellow zone. The other team stand on the green zone.
That's cool. Jamie, we're split.
Housemates, you're not listening. One team moved to the green zone.
We got it. The green machine.
Like,
oh, second
one.
Hey.
What's going on? Why are they doing
this? Getting
nervous.
Stuff. Ready?
The teams for the next round are Galen, John, Anna, Katie. You're competing against Camilla, Karen, Ashley, and Jamie. Karen. As an original captain of tonight's games, your team will have the advantage of competing second.
Ooh.
Second team, select a captain now.
Galen. You're me. One, two, bang. Yep.
Galen, you are captain. All housemates to the holding area. That is all.
Okay, there you go. They're the teams. Yes. Interesting stuff.
Yeah.
We'll talk about the teams and the captains and more after the break. Eight housemates, two teams, but there can only be one winner of Friday Night Live. Thing to happen on television since the invention of the remote control. I'm Mike Goldman, and tonight the housemates are dressed as cavemen. The games are well and truly underway, and already Big Brother has sent seven housemates to the bench of shame. But eight remain. Whose teams are you choosing now, guys?
They've got two new teams, and Bree's going to go with the breakaway group. I'm going to go with Karen. I'm going to swap teams. Yep. Karen's still a captain of one of the teams, and I think she's got a very good team. Let's have a look at a couple more profiles here. We've got Camilla first up, who comes in.
Camilla Parker-Poles.
Straight into round two, and Camilla... No, it's not, Mikey. It's not Camilla Parker-Poles. And I think that is an advantage. She doesn't look anything like her. She hasn't got head like a half-eaten pasty. A disadvantage is... She's got a very faulty gaydar at the moment.
She doesn't need it during the game.
A lot of girls do. Let's have a look at another one.
Put your gaydar into service.
Ashley's a labourer, and I think he's a very big competitor here. One of the pros, he's a very good 10-pin bowler.
Mm.
So if we have any 10-pin bowling caveman challenges tonight, he's doing well. But one disadvantage is that he's allergic to cats.
Oh, no.
We have heaps of cats in the house.
Maybe that fur on his head or the jacket he's wearing. Lots of fur. Maybe he'll start sneezing. Bree, what about your team?
Maybe Claire will have like leftover cat hair on her body and he'll start sneezing everywhere.
Mm. Yeah, he could shave it off for her.
Nice. Well, I'm going to go with Galen's team. Now, let's have a look at one profile we haven't seen, which is John.
Mm-hmm.
Let's take a look Johnny. Here. Now, a pro is that he's an extreme sportsman, does every sport, everything there is
what
to
does
do.
That mean, extreme?
But a con is that he has really waxy hair.
Extreme sportsman, uses, you know, like he jumps out of buildings and base jumps and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, he uses like surfboard wax in his hair, so you know, I mean, might be an advantage, might be a big disadvantage.
He's got grip if he falls on his head.
Yes.
He's a good footballer too, apparently, Johnny, in country Victoria, so he's got a competitive streak too.
Hey, what about just the last couple of days, David's big coming out?
I know.
Oh, wasn't that great television? Wasn't that massive?
I know. I was on the edge of my seat, literally, like looking at the TV.
Do you think he left it a little bit too long to come out? Because do you think he embarrassed Camilla?
I'm really undecided, to tell you the truth, because I understand completely that he wanted to go in there as a personality.
Yeah.
No, I'm going to change my... No, I really don't think he left it too long. It's his prerogative, it's his business, and it shouldn't matter.
What about when he was in the diary room and he said, I just want my mum to be proud of me?
I know. I cried my eyes out.
He was worried about, you know, how everyone in his small country town would handle it when his mum goes to church, like if she gets strange looks and everything like
that. You know what, if I didn't know though, I wouldn't have picked it. He's just, you wouldn't pick it in him at all. He's just a good, like, country boy.
What is going on with the patch with Tilly?
Yeah, well, that's what I was going to say, you know.
What's going on there?
He went from being the most popular housemate on the internet poll, you know, after his big coming out, because everyone was so proud and happy for him that, you know, it was such a big deal. And then went off and pashed Tilly, and I'm just wondering if it's going to affect him at all.
Why did he do that? Last night on Up Late, it was the first pash of Big Brother 06. And he's done it like three or four times.
It's over
and
over again.
Camilla's sitting right behind him. His best friend in the house.
He can pass you every line.
Okay, well, the victorious team have been split like a pizza on The Biggest Loser, and Big Brother tells me that we're ready for round two. So let's head down to the arena.
We just go run.
This is Big Brother.
They just
housemates. This next game is the Stone Age Speedway. You'll race two laps of the obstacle course. The first lap forwards, the second lap backwards. The fastest team is through to the next round. Teams, you must complete all obstacles, but take great care when you reach the final obstacle. Ninjas, remove the covers.
Ninjas?
And the pit of mousetraps.
They're not set up.
They wouldn't be set up.
Chowder!
Just bow. Just...
Galen's team, prepare to race.
That's funny.
There's no way to...
Ready? Gotta run.
Run.
Are you kidding me?
They wouldn't be set up.
And they're up and racing round two.
You got a good start. Come on.
We'll let you know now that is not real dinosaur poop.
What were they thinking?
Okay, those mouse traps, believe it or not, aren't actually real mouse traps, but the housemates don't know that.
Gee, slow down, guys. Every KO.
No,
it's the sliding car.
You must do the course upright.
Not on your knees.
Now, a lot of people think that they didn't have the technology back in these days, and that's why they used to run in the cars, but petrol was $1.40 back then as well, and that's why they used to do it like this.
What kind of car is it?
I think by next week
we will
be.
Do you know what this car is? This is an original Datsun 1A.
It's not the 180.
One of the original Datsuns, yes.
Okay, oh no, the feet on the mousetraps, look out!
The outer!
No, they're not real mousetraps.
Yes, they are.
Now, this is second lap, and they have to do it backwards. You reckon it was hard enough going forwards?
There's nothing funnier than people falling over.
Yeah,
they don't have airbags in their car either.
Oh, yeah, and
there's a wedgie.
Ow.
Hold on.
Listen to that communication. Listen to that teamwork.
Get there. Get there. Oh.
Come on.
No. I think they're doing all right at the moment.
Oh, that's harsh. Hold on. That's it.
You must do the course upright.
That's a good slide. Look, actually, you can hear them just panting. They're going quite hard out there.
Watch out for the little tipper room.
They're stuck.
It's not a pretty car, but it beats walking.
Yeah, it's true.
It's the same as Fred Flintstone's car that he used to drive to work every day on the Flintstones.
Really?
What was his boss's name? He used to...
Oh. It's a space suit.
It's a Jetsons.
That's a Jetsons.
Yes! Keep reversing.
Well done. Very safety conscious.
Yeah, they're going to go under the vault here.
Don't muck up the hair.
You're weak.
Anna's going down like a model with a pimple.
Oh, no.
Anna, you're fine.
Cut the corkies.
Look at the other team. They all think they're real.
Turn around.
Go back. There you go. We just checked the times on that. I reckon that was pretty good, guys. What do you think?
Look, I'm a little bit disappointed. They seem to be off to a rocky start.
Let's have a listen to them down there.
This is Big Brother. You completed the course in 3 minutes and 1 second.
Yes, what?
That's good. Now,
all housemates to the holding area.
I reckon that was great, but they were freaking out around the mousetraps, weren't they?
Yeah.
They thought they were real. They still think they're real, and that's good because that means the next team that goes through will think they're real as well.
Mm. Right.
If they figured it out.
Massive advantage, though, watching that then. And what about how stupid they were just running straight into the slime and just falling straight over?
How would you have done it, Pitsy?
You've got to go
carefully.
Yeah,
Mr. Professional.
Mr. Slime.
Cool, calm and collected, Mike. That's the way you've got to do it. You just can't chuck yourself into it. But 3 minutes and 1 second's not too bad.
I reckon the team worked very well together, and I think we'll have a little look at a replay here. We've got of them having a stack. We always like to see them fall over, so why not?
They got a good bit of distance up with that slide,
there's
though.
There's the old slip and slide there.
That was well done. A good time. After the break, Karen, Camilla, Ashley, Jamie, they have 3 minutes and 1 second to beat. I'm Mike Goldman, and you've made an excellent choice because you're watching Friday Night Live. Goldman, and as you can see above my head, that was very good. That was very quick, wasn't it? No, not above my head. I'm talking about the plasma. Yes, the arena is awash with cavemen. Well, actually, they're just housemates, believe it or not. But for the purpose of tonight, let's just pretend. Mm. Before the break, Galen, Katie, John and Anna slipped and slid their way around the prehistoric racing track and recorded a time of 3 minutes and 1 second. Now, Karen, Camilla, Ashley and Jamie will get their chance. How do you reckon they'll go? Will they win? Will they get a better time, audience? What do you reckon? Any idea? No. Don't think that they will. Well, the fake mousetraps, obviously, Galen's team have figured that out. And Anna yelled out to the other team at the top of her voice, "Oh, I think I got cut by one of the mousetraps. I've hurt my foot." So a bit of psychological game.
Ooh, reverse psychology. No, what's going on?
I don't think she's that smart. I think she honestly thought she got hit on the foot by a mousetrap.
Bit of attention, you reckon, Friday?
Yeah,
no,
could be.
Look, I think it's all strategy.
Okay, well, we'll see. Only one way to find out. Let's head down to the arena.
This is Big Brother. Karen's team, it's now your turn to race.
Okay, you ready, kids?
You must run the first lap forwards and the second lap backwards. Take great care through the pit of mousetraps. Prepare to race.
Just power through that mousetrap shit.
Okay. Off and racing for the second round.
Do it, Mike. Cool, calm and collected, see?
Yep. But they have the advantage of seeing the other teams around day two.
Ready?
Let's have a listen to their communication.
Off.
Guys,
Karen, you right? Are you right? Let's go.
Okay.
They're grunting like real cavemen.
Apologies, team.
Not a bad start by Karen's team.
Karen, Jamie, Ashley and Camilla.
Yeah. The two lads are leading them off there.
This is Camilla's first crack at the game. She was in the first round.
Good to hear the other competitors giving him a little bit of support there.
in the Datsun 1A.
Great car, the old Datsun 1A.
Here come the mouse traps. Let's see if they are freaked out and they know that
they're. Oh, that's not a bad effort. Got to get up quick. That's it, Camilla, good girl. Did you look at
I think you might be right, Fitzy. I think Anna actually did think.
Yeah, I think she did too.
She thinks she did get bitten by the mousetrap.
Now, I reckon they'd have a slight lead here going into the second lap.
Oh, they're nearly going sideways there.
Oh, this is taking
check it out.
You must walk backwards.
Yeah, thanks, big brother.
Did you just ring him, Bree?
I did. Okay, we're there.
Come on.
Down. Get me down. Are you ready?
You ready?
Yep. Come on, boys. You fine?
Got him. Yep. Got him. Now what are you doing? Oh, jeez.
Not there yet.
That was a good effort there. They did not fall down in that pool of goo at all.
It's a dinosaur.
Both flats.
See, this is
down the ramp.
Once it's already slippery, you're just gone. You have no chance.
I reckon they're probably ahead here. What do you reckon?
Yeah, I'm thinking that, maybe.
What's the audience reckon? Are they winning?
Up the ramp.
Karen, Jamie, Ashley and Camilla.
Get on it.
Remember, the time to beat is 3 minutes and 1 second.
Okay, you ready?
We're going down.
There's a lot at stake here, Fitzy. The rewards room, nomination points. The new prizes in the boxes we're going to reveal very soon.
We do now?
Whoa!
Handing out the chores. I'm talking about handing out the chores.
Let's
hand them out.
Let's listen to the last leg.
Oh, this is so close. I reckon this would have been really close, Mikey.
Who was that whose leg just went out? That would have hurt. Did the splits. Next to Karen. Who's that?
Camilla.
Camilla just did the splits. That would have hurt.
This is it. This is the end of the final stretch.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, they know about the mouse traps now, I reckon. Final stretch and they're home. Nice work.
I'm sorry if I was like, get out. I was talking to myself more than anyone.
This is Big Brother. Galen, Anna, John, and Katie. You completed the course in 3 minutes and 1 second. Karen, Jamie, Ashley, Camilla, you completed the course in 3 minutes and 5 seconds.
You're joking.
Galen's team, you are through to the next round.
Yeah, oh, nice.
Karen, Jamie, Ashley, and Camilla, you are out of tonight's games. All housemates to the holding area.
Bam, bam, out of the games. Goodbye, Karen, Jamie, Ashley and Camilla.
We were really quick in between. Wait, wasn't it 3 minutes and what?
So Galen, John, Katie and Anna are through to the final round. Let's start talking about the rewards room. Who will Galen take to the rewards room?
Himself.
Yes.
Amira. Okay, who will Waxhead John take to the rewards room?
Definitely one of the girls.
I reckon
what about
Anna?
Nah, Johnny's good mates with the Blakes. He'll take one of the boys in here. I'm not quite sure. Maybe Dino.
Just because
you
take
mates
a
with
boy?
Dino.
No.
Yeah.
What about David? You'd probably take him, wouldn't you?
I'd take David in there.
What about Katie?
So would I.
Katie would take Jamie, I think, because they're madly in love.
Oh, definitely. Oh, look, that's a speculation there.
Well, they sleep in the same bed together.
That
they
doesn't
do,
mean
they
in
spoon
love.
And they cuddle and then they did a
they're
frontal
getting along
spoon.
Very, very well. Yeah, and let's hope love blossoms.
They've been holding hands. I think they're going to be the first to properly. Kiss
romance.
In the house, if you know what I mean by properly kiss, where it actually means something.
Yeah.
Not
they
that
like
superficial David and Tilly nothing pash. And what about Anna? Who will she take?
Well, that's a tough one, I don't know.
I don't know if she's got many friends in the house. She might, I don't know, Anna may be good friends with the Crystal, because they're both quite young, so the girls will go in there and
She may have a secret crush. Who knows? Maybe she's just not showing it as obviously as what the other girls are.
Well, the excitement is at boiling point, and I'm, for one, I need a fan for a few minutes to just fan me off, so thank you very much.
No.
After the break, I'm reliably informed that there will be spears thrown at massive targets.
Ooh.
And one of the housemates' bottoms will be the bullseye. Guess you could say that'd have to be a crack shot.
Oh, that is a belter, Mike. And because we have a bit of a dinosaur theme, you could say that one of them could be a megasaurus.
Oh! Fitzy!
Fitzy!
Champagne,
you
guys.
Idiot. Stay where you are, back in a minute on Friday Night Live. Up until now, the housemates have been playing as teams. Now they're going head-to-head, monobrow to monobrow, caveman style. Tonight, our housemates are cavemen. But only one can be the king of the cave. And who will the king of the cave be, Bree?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe Galen, I'll put my tip on to win this tonight.
Galen, John, Katie or Anna Fitzy?
I'm saying Johnny, little Johnny. Footballer, yes. I'm going Johnny.
Want to put Surfer Wax in his hair? Okay, cool. Only four left, but that is three too many. Let's head down to the arena.
Nicks, stick from a tree.
Get off, Nicks.
Yeah.
This is Big Brother.
Good luck.
Yeah. Go, John.
John. Katie. Anna. Galen. You'll take turns to throw two spears at the target. The two housemates with the highest scores go through to the final round. Housemates, in the center of the target is a hole for the bullseye. The bullseye will be one of your housemates' bottoms.
Ash!
Players, you have 10 seconds to decide which one of the losers will be the bullseye.
Yeah,
is it better? No,
I'd say not. Of course
we've already seen your ass. It's a good ass. A bit hairy, but it's
good.
A bit
hairy, too.
Bit fuzzy.
I'm going for it. Tilly.
What is your decision?
Tilly or Ash?
Ash. Go, Ash. Do it for the team.
Ashley,
feel me.
Go to the target.
Get
in the red shorts. And firmly place your bottom into the hole.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
Get there. But does he have to flash it or what?
I bet he's got like one of them bums on it.
I hope he can flash it.
Special red shorts with a bullseye on it.
Yeah.
Wear my duck tee.
And we got this.
Yeah, they've got bum cheeks on them.
Yes. Yeah, that's awesome.
That's awesome. It's awesome, dude.
Look at him.
It's big. Oh, what's that in the back?
This is Big Brother. First housemate, take a spear. Stand behind the white line and throw only on Big Brother's command.
I bet you'll get one.
He's out, I think.
I bet I won't get it.
Yeah.
John, throw now.
Oh, no!
Oh, that was a hopeless shot. Look at Ashley jiggling his little bum around.
You could do some real damage.
You scored 2 points. Katie, move into position.
That's a terrible shot.
You know, John's got 2 points.
I don't think I'd even hit the board, so I think that's pretty good.
It's gonna hurt if Ashley gets it straight on the puck.
He's throw
hurt
now.
One of my... Actually, one of my favourite ice creams was a chocolate.
Katie, you scored 2 points. Anna, move into position now.
Go Anna. Come on, Anna.
Do it, Anna.
Anna, throw now.
Right on his butt.
Oh, Anna down there, had to hold it.
Go, Anna.
Put your...
Oh, not too bad. Nice. She's hit the lead.
Great.
She takes the lead.
Ashley's enjoying
Anna,
this.
You scored 3 points. Galen, move into position.
Oh, no, Galen.
Oh, Galen's going to wind up here.
Get it, Galen. Pretty strong guy. This could hurt.
Throw now.
Oh, is that three or four? Let's listen to Big Bra.
Galen, you scored 4 points.
Yay!
John,
hits the
move into position.
So Galen and Anna are leading at the moment.
All right, let's go.
so wrong.
Slam throw shot. Now.
Oh!
Terrible!
Deplorable, Johnny.
Oh, that's great.
John, you scored 1 point, giving you a total of 3.
Ooh, see you later, John boy.
Bye, Johnny, you're out of here.
Just doing one shot.
Katie, move into position.
Galen, Katie and Anna. Only ones left in the competition. Who will win tonight's Friday night games?
She needs a bullseye.
Throw now.
It's going.
Oh, she's on 4. And a little wave from Ashley.
What'd she get?
Katie, you scored 4 points, giving you a total of 6.
Ooh, this is going to be interesting. She's like Naomi Campbell with a telephone. Whack!
It's better.
The Kerper.
Throw now.
She gets 6, so, and then she's out of it.
Anna, you scored 3 points, giving you a total of 6 points.
Oh, Katie and Anna are 6.
Oh, Katie
Galen,
and Anna are tied, sorry.
Into position.
Right. Oh, I hope he gets 1.
Yeah.
Galen is on 4.
He only needs a 3 to hit the lead.
He needs a 3.
Galen, at least throw 3 now.
Oh, he's got the bullseye. I think Galen's got it.
That outfit actually suits Galen, doesn't it? It looks good.
He looks hot.
This is Big Brother. Galen, you are through to the final round.
Yay!
John, you have been eliminated. Stand to one side. Katie, Anna, you have tied. Each of you will throw one spear. The housemate with the highest score will advance to the final round.
Oh, it's the Britney Spears off. Who will be bottom of the chart?
Wouldn't mind bringing a couple of Britney Spears now.
Anna, move into position.
Oh, you mean beers like Britney Spears? Okay, cool.
Hey, Jamie, can I have a drink?
Anna, throw now.
Track then.
Looks like a 3.
Anna, you scored 3 points.
That's not too bad.
Katie,
move into position.
I'm almost hoping Katie gets this because I want to see her take Jamie into the rewards room.
No!
Can't you wait till after Ashley?
Throw now. This is Big Brother. Katie, you scored a bullseye. You are a winner and you are through to the final round.
Yeah!
All housemates to the holding area.
There you go. Well, it's Katie and Galen through to the final round.
How exciting.
Nice throwing, and I bet Ashley's glad that no one got a real bullseye, if you know what I mean. So, we've got a replay here of, I believe it's Galen and that power shot that he did, and Ashley feeling the pain. Oh!
There was a bit of heat on that one. He knew there was a bit of heat on that one.
But it's not as if he's worried. Like, he's sticking it right out the hole there, saying, yeah, come and get me. Well, I guess you could say John and Anna really bottomed out there.
Oh, that's a beauty, Mike. Well done.
Yeah, sorry, good. I probably won't do that one.
Cut that one off.
Okay. So it's Galen and Katie in the final. What in the wide world of sports do we make of that, hosts?
Oh, look, I'm excited because these are two people that are going to be really interesting to see who they take to the rewards room. Katie and Jamie, love could blossom, you know, once they get a bit of privacy.
I would put $1 million on it that Katie would pick Jamie to go to the rewards room.
Oh, that's a big bet.
I don't have $1 million, so...
I'm just trying to think who Galen would pick to take into the rewards room.
Yeah.
Well, he's good mates with everyone in the house, actually. Yeah. Among the housemates, I heard them talking earlier today, they said he's actually the most popular.
Yeah, everyone loves him. So
he's going to have his own show. Everybody loves Galen.
Yeah. I think he holds his cards close to his chest, and so it'll be interesting to see if he does have a bit of a crush.
Mm. Oh, okay, well, Katie and Galen go head-to-head for the most important prize since the dawn of time. Stick around to see who will take it out. This is Friday Night Live. The grotesque Fitzy Fitzgerald.
Oh, that's a bit rough. Get on with it. Get on with it.
No, isn't he? Don't you reckon? He's a bit of a looker.
I don't know, Mike, is he?
What are you trying to...
It's grotesque. That's what I said. Oh, well, we're
Actually,
seconds
I've got
away.
Something to tell you. I just want to be honest and... Oh, no, no, it's all right. Get on with it.
We're seconds from finding out whether Galen or Katie will be the first Friday Night Live champion of 2006. And win what, kids?
Oh, we've got heaps. We've got the rewards room.
There's a time for this.
Okay, let's do it one at a time, okay? Let's start small and we'll get big. Put that back under. Okay, chores, handing out the chores to the housemates.
What about the rewards rooms, the big one?
The reward rooms.
Yes.
The ability to take nominations points off.
People. And then we've got a box. Yeah. Emma!
Emma! Yay! What's in the boxes? What's in the boxes?
Mike, I'm just going to open mine.
Are we allowed to?
We do it now?
No, not
no,
yet.
No, I don't think we're allowed yet. Well, no, as you can yet. See, the ninjas are working frantically to prepare the last game. Last year, those ninjas became celebrities in their own right. This year, as a special treat to you all, they've decided to share their special ninja wisdom with a secret ninja tip. Ninja tip of the week.
Always looking for a toothpick? Every time you cut your toenails, keep the clippings in a small container. They're great toothpick substitutes.
Okay, that's tip number 37.
That is, I've kissed that mouth. That's disgusting.
You went out with a ninja, didn't you?
Yeah,
that's
for
right,
a while.
You did too.
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. All right, moving right along, the business in hand. Galen and Katie are about to play off in the final game, and I don't need to remind you of how massive the prize is. Let's go down to the arena for the last time to see who will bring home the Brontosaurus burgers.
This is Big Brother. Galen, Katie, in the final round, you will be headhunting. You must use your hunting stick to knock your opponent's head off. You must remain in the yellow zone at all times. This round will be scored best of three. Finalists, prepare to compete.
And they're away for the headhunting final round.
Now, Katie is a little underdog here. Galen is like 7 foot nine and she's 2 foot three. So she's going to find it hard.
Katie, look at
the underdog.
Look at Galen. Galen's blaming his tools. That was a great effort by Katie.
Katie, you have scored 1 point.
Oh, sick.
Prepare to compete.
Oh, sick.
Yeah. Oh, she is just hilarious.
Just like David and Goliath. It's Davina.
The toupee came off.
That was better than Ricky Ponting. He's just covered by their head for four.
He must have played T-ball when he was a kid.
Now he looks like Bert. The top of that.
That was brilliant.
We've done it.
This is Big Brother Galen. You have now scored 1 point. Score is 1 point each. Prepare to compete.
This is the decider.
She wants her head.
Galen in the red corner. Katie in the blue.
Go. He's going to wind up again and knock her head off.
Oh! Off with her head!
That was real!
Again.
Is that it?
This is Big Brother. Galen, you've scored a 2nd point. You are the winner of the Friday night games. Approach the dinosaur and collect your trophy.
Oh, yes. The dinosaur.
That dinosaur's gonna
kill. Yes.
Is that a ninja dinosaur?
This is Big Brother. Congratulations, Galen. Losing housemates, stand up and celebrate your champion.
Well done.
Galen. Hey, little fella.
Oh, it's got apple juice in it.
Housemates, it's time to return to the house.
My eyes were falling, boy.
Well done, mate.
Oi.
Hey.
There you go. Galen, the first winner. He's got the rewards room, he's handing out nominations points, he's handing out chores, and he gets the secret box.
Oh, the mystery prize!
The mystery box. Okay, let's have a look at a replay there of his final winning moment. It was very good of Katie to get that first one, though.
Yeah, watch this, ready?
He nearly decapitated
Andrew Simons.
There goes his head. It was rough in prehistoric times, and Katie throwing down her pole in disgust, and Galen did that with a droopy pole as well.
He did very, very well. He cover drove her head for four both times. Now, this is the big thing. Who's he going to take into the room?
I don't know. I've got absolutely no idea. I'm lost for words for once.
Well, he hangs out with everyone in the house. I don't think he has any particular favourites, but the night is not over. The physical games may have finished, but the mental games have only just begun. After the break, find out who Galen will take to the rewards room and find out just what are in the three boxes. Welcome back. I'm Mike Goldman, and you've made the very hairy choice of watching Friday Night Live. Galen has just been crowned Captain Caveman. And the housemates are all gathered on the lounge. So let's go live to the house.
Oh, yeah, it's all right.
This is Big Brother. Galen, to the diary room immediately.
Oh.
Don't sit.
Galen, sit down.
I've got a really wet. Does it matter?
Sit down. Galen, as winner of tonight's games, you have won four prizes.
Yes.
The right to allocate household chores. The power to affect nominations. A special prize you'll learn of later. And access to the rewards room for the next two nights. Galen, you may invite just one other housemate to spend this time with you. The rewards room is entered from the back garden. To gain entry, use the swipe cards you see next to you. Galen.
Yep.
Who do you wish to invite and why?
For her gallant effort coming second place, Katie.
Galen.
Yes.
Go out and inform your housemates of your decision. That is all.
Thank you. So I've decided to pick for her gallant effort in coming second, Katie.
Black's
supposed to be slimming.
Are you sure, man? I don't care. Yeah.
You must have to swipe it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is that room over there, girl?
Yeah, no, it's
just leave it next to the blue thing.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Beep.
Oh, are you sure? You don't have to, hey?
Mm-hmm. Oh, you guys need to watch some good
DVDs.
Yeah.
TV!
Yeah. Yes. Oh, no, do you?
Yeah.
Love TV.
This is Big Brother.
I forget Fox have comedy.
Housemates, only Galen and Katie may enter the rewards room. No one else is allowed in, and nothing may be removed from the room. Galen,
yes.
Katie, the rewards room is now open.
Let's go.
Do we have clothes?
I don't know. Maybe they've got something that... I don't know, do you reckon
just that? Just jammies.
Jammies, that's all we need. Mine are ripped on the line.
See ya.
Bye, guys.
We didn't even say bye.
I know, we're just like, see, we're eating.
Where are we going?
Is this it? We act like we know where we're going.
Oh.
Is that it?
Get in there.
Oh.
Oh, disco.
Oh, my God. So much
let's eat now.
Look, yeah, let's eat now.
It's hot.
And look at all the lollies. Oh, this is...
Fuck the
yeah, yeah.
I don't think they're giving us one.
Who cares? Oh, where's the TV? Soaked, oh, are we allowed to sit on that?
What do we do with clothes?
Look at all this food. It's like an abundance of food. Wow. I'm so excited. Thank you so much.
Yeah, sick. Let's eat.
Oh, I was a sitting duck there.
All right.
Hmm? Oh, look at this. Ready? Hmm. Yes, look at that.
Nah, for sure, mate. Oh, it's probably a...
Oh, it's a hard
remote bit. For plasma lift.
You're joking. There's got to be a plasma lift.
There it is. It's there.
What? Oh!
Yeah.
We're
in.
Oh,
got some rice. Go.
That's all right. Mm. What is plasma?
That's it, that big roller thing. See the screen?
Mm-hmm.
What do you reckon that's the window?
We can get drunk. Do that wine. I don't like that stuff,
huh? I like it when I haven't had anything with flavour for the last couple of days.
Oh, my God. Taste that.
You have it.
Mmm.
It's like this.
Huh? Bubbly?
Yeah. How much fun was that?
I can't believe... Yeah, knock his...
That's the plasma, mate.
Oh, yeah. Do you reckon it is? That's the plasma there.
It's good to open these, man.
Oh, I'm pro at it here.
You do it.
Because
sauce.
Oh my God.
You know,
is it?
Yeah.
That's my favourite. That is that chili? Do you like chili?
Yeah, I think so.
Mmm. No, the poo trail, no more prawns. Oh my God. Yeah. Let's taste everything.
We're in here for 48 hours. 2 days.
Yeah. I say we save this for tomorrow. Drunk and then walk around.
During the day?
Yeah, do you want it?
We've got a lot of beer as well. Do you drink beer?
Sometimes. I've got cruises and stuff.
That's all right.
Yeah? Do you want to...
No, I'm as up now. Celebrate
now?
The win.
Okay. You celebrate the win. Oh, look, what up? Ooh.
Did you did well.
Huh? Mm. Oh, talk about underdog.
That was sick fun.
You know what I felt like? You That's my dad all the way. Is that the only one we got? I'm still hungry.
Oh, no. What happened to the champagne?
I got distracted. Right, love.
Ooh.
Oh, my God.
All right.
All right. Flintstones. Oh, I have this one at home. I honestly got...
Sick.
I think I got mine
now. Oh, there you go. Having a bit of fun in the rewards room, Katie and Galen. And did you see the look on poor old Jamie's face. You've taken away my Katie because they're bed buddies.
Yeah.
They've been cuddling every night. So I think there might be a bit of jealousy happening there.
She's actually, Bree, you're a big fan of Katie.
I love her.
A funny girl. I'm starting
she's
to
hilarious.
Like her quite a bit.
She's got the best sense of humour. And it's Friday night and she probably got her chicken.
She did. She was eating her chicken soup. What's she doing right now? What's going on?
Oh, Galen's choking.
Just having a few drinks and a few laughs, Galen, the male model.
And that was a good effort by Galen.
Yeah.
He
yeah,
didn't know who to pick, so he's gone, all right, yeah, whoever's come second, I'll just take Cardi in.
I think he might be a strong competitor the whole way through Friday Night Live.
You tipping an early winner,
Bree? Yeah, but you know what? You don't want to win every week necessarily because it gives people a reason to nominate you.
Yeah.
Okay, well, Galen doesn't know. What he doesn't know is that the rewards room will not be the only reward he'll be receiving tonight. No sirree. Remember these? Yes, the boxes! Straight after this show, one of our ninjas will take these boxes down to the house and Galen will get to open one of them and win the prize inside.
Ooh.
I can now exclusively reveal that inside the box number one is a little statue of
Buddha.
A Thailand god Buddha. And it's actually also an all-inclusive holiday to Thailand.
Oh.
Yes. If Galen picks this box, he and a friend friend will enjoy the experience of a lifetime. He will read this. It says, you've won a trip for two trekking by elephant and bamboo raft to the hill tribes of northern Thailand, courtesy of adventure holiday specialists Kumaka Worldwide. All flights, food and accommodation and guides included. Kumaka Worldwide. What an awesome prize.
That is going to be wicked. Is it my turn?
It's a box too.
All right, are you ready? A spring roll.
Oh, it's a Thai spring roll.
No,
oh,
are you ready?
Oh, that's disgraceful.
Are you ready?
It's a Chico roll.
Hey, that's for them. Leave it alone. Now, if you choose this box, you have won a Thai banquet for you and two other housemates of your choice. This banquet will take place tomorrow night. Please advise Big Brother tonight who your guests will be. Now, this is massive because what you have to understand is that the housemates have been on staples all week, which means no flavour at all.
Fair call, Brady.
And this thing that I just snapped as well. So put that in there. So, a Thai holiday, a Thai banquet, or what's in box number three?
Well, if we're going with a theme of Thai, it's a bow tie!
Which box will Galen open? I can hardly bear the tension. All will be revealed on Up Late in just 1 hour's time with special guest last year's Big Brother housemate, Logan David.
Oh, nice.
And don't forget our special surprise eviction on Sunday night, plus live nominations and Big Brother Unforgettable on Monday. Ooh. All the highlights of Big Brother over the last 5 years, so you'll probably see these two kissing again.
Oh.
Well, should we get a reenactment of that
now?
No.
We have to wait until Monday night.
Where's that Chico off?
Okay. It's been an absolute pleasure, Bree. Fitzy, it's been an experience.
Yeah, thanks,
I'm Mike Goldman. You've been watching Friday Night Live. Good night.
Welcome back. Hollywood hottie Christy Swanson is attempting a very difficult trick. Oh, that's gotta hurt.
It's the competition that scores 9.5 for laughs. Skating with Celebrities starts now.
This program brought to you from Dreamworld, the home of Big Brother.